Welcome to the Wise Guy channel and the backyard project. Today is going to be totally epic. He is assembling and installing the patio smoke plexiglass gazebo. Let's watch together how the Wise Guy installs the gazebo solo style. Please remember to hit the like button and subscribe.
Just got back with the gazebo. Okay. Our weather's starting to get kind of nasty on us. All right, look at that thing over there. All right, let's hurry up, open this. Now we're being rained on. Weather out here, hot 1 minute, rain the next. Let's finish getting this inside the shed. Yeah, just busted everything in. Man, the shelves are coming in handy. All right, got everything organized. All right, as soon as it stops raining, we'll pop out there. I'm sure the sun will come and the UV rays dry everything up fast, but we'll start building that gazebo. All right, what you're looking at is I'm gonna put ballast into this leg, weight it down. We're gonna use the fine, compact, artificial turf. We're just gonna fill this up like so. Get about 30 pounds in it, and we'll show you how we cap it off in a minute or so. Let's get to shoveling. All right, what you're looking at is the cap, the footer. Let's go ahead and put it in place using our screw gun to make it quick and easy. That's how we do it. All right, we've been using the plastic to protect it. Let's go ahead and pull it off. Give it a quick wipe down. This thing is about now, I don't know, 25, 30 pounds in it. Let's put it with the other one. Two more to go. Now that we've got the ballast in all four legs, roughly 30 pounds minimum, I would say. It could even be 35. We know we got 120 pounds for sure, which will help anchor it, especially on a day like today where the weather ain't cooperating. But it's keeping it cool. All right, the wise guy on the gazebo just got thrown a curveball. All right, supposed to have four per Miss Wise Guy. You keeping it organized? Did you check in the inventory? Yes. But what it was all bubble wrapped up. I could, yeah, I'll take responsibility for it. Here's how all right, looks like I found the missing pieces. Okay, I'm the last member. All right, got some vice grips on. Hopefully they'll just come right on out. There's one. Tell me when I tip this upside down, the other one. Yes. All right. We don't have to manufacture no brackets. How they got in here, the last piece, I don't know. All right. Yeah. We pretty much straightened it out, put those brackets in. Putting the angle braces on the legs. We got three more to go. Let's get to work. Thank you. God, we just finished putting up all the 45 angle braces for the legs. All right, we've been smoking along. In fact, that's funny, because what's next, once you see the roof, is the smoke plexiglass. Anyway, it's basically all assembled, framed out. That's the next pretty much gazebo member to install, the plexiglass roof. Let's get back to work on the gazebo.
The wise guy has been smoking along, and Mrs. Wise Guy came out to make a request. Let's watch how the wise guy handles it, and to all you lame workers, watch and learn.
All right, what we're looking at is a request from Basie, Mrs. Wise Guy. You can't see it, but in certain light, there's like three small, you know, like cardings in this thing, right? So she asked me if I could pretty much switch it out to this one over here that doesn't have any dents. The reason why is when the sun hits it and she's looking through this window here, she can see three small dents in it. All right, because I don't want to be one of those guys, those lame guys, because those dents actually are in it, right? And we're talking about there's eight combined screws, okay? Should take the wise guy about 15 minutes. Let's swap this center rail with that one over there.
For the lame worker that is just too lazy and rather make up an excuse or tell a homeowner they might make it worse if they switch the components, watch how the wise guy fixes it quick and easy.
What you're looking at is what I call a helper. So all we need is a 2x4, that's the helper, with a wood clamp. Anyway, I clamped it to the pretty much gazebo where we want it to support itself, giving it an additional leg to stand on. We got another one going over here. Okay, let's get unzipping these screws with this power screw gun. About 5 minutes into it, this cross member is off. It's down here. It's the primo one. We're about ready to drop this one. Only one bolt holding it up. Here's the damage area. In fact, the powder coating is loose. Good call by Mrs. Wise Guy. We'll put it over there where it doesn't matter. Let's get this one off and reattached on the far side. All right, as you see, the helpers are doing their job. Okay, let's get this reassembled. Just got that side all buttoned up. Now put on that good looking cross member right there and make Miss Wise Guy happy. All back together. Took about 20 minutes. Now it looks nice and clean. Eye of sight, when she looks out the window, or me, we'll see a perfect gazebo. Just put on the second part of the ridge cap, as well as the fan hook. All right, we're on the next phase. We're coming in on completion, which is putting up the smoke plexiglass, basically on the roof. I was looking at the box. Yeah, it says pure and easy. Okay, I would say yes. So far by myself, don't forget I had to change out these center rails, so I made a little mistake. I got about 4 to 5 hours into it. Let's get on putting the plexiglass up. Yeah, I say this basically manufacturer is living up to its name, Pure Easy. Halfway there, let's finish this roof up. Man, it looks nice from every angle. Let's take you outside and show you a better look at the backyard gazebo. I believe Miss Wise Guy got it at Amazon for under $800. Well, that's a wrap for today. Miss Wise Guy got brick pavers. She got the gazebo. We even cleaned up that center rail. We're going to see you on the next video at the Backyard Project.
Thank you for watching. We hope you join us on the upcoming videos to the Backyard Project. Please remember to hit the like button and subscribe.